Hey, what's happening, everybody? This is Robert the Leather Cowboy Muhammad with Premier Leather Crafters here in Alabama. And I wasn't going to do a video today, but I had a student of mine that's coming up in my new workshop, leather workshop, that's coming up starting June the 3rd. This is going to run from June the 3rd to June the 22nd, to where I go in and I host this event every year. To where it's an eight Saturday program, to where I go in and I teach people who are interested in doing this leather crafting business, and I bring in leather crafters from out of town, and they give their insight and their knowledge and share a lot about this leather business. I worked a great deal. Premier Leather Crafters worked a great deal with Tandy, to where the students are getting their tools at a great price. Actually, they get the deluxe kit for it's a price that we were able to manage and incorporate into the registration fee, which is only $140, and $80 of that is going toward tools and different kits and things that Tandy has worked out. A lot cheaper than what I started out with, the price that I paid when I first started. Actually, I didn't have a deluxe kit when I started out. I just started buying different tools, and I was taking the classes and buying up more tools that I liked, and tried to expand my craft and expand my creativity. But this video is going to be called Doing a Lot with a Little. And this stemmed from a conversation from one of the students that was, he was like, man, I'm only getting seven tools. He said, how am I going to be able to do the stuff that you do with only seven tools? And I'm like, man, I said, really? You have seven tools, but you have 35 different designs and prints that you can come up with. Now, so again, some crafters may tell you something completely different. I'm going to be a realist, and I'm just going to tell you like this. You can, once you, and I've always told in every video that I've ever done, learn your tools. Learn what your tools can do. Learn what different shapes and designs that you can create with your tool, as well as learn how to take those tools and make the leather itself create a different shape or pattern or print. So now what I've done, I've selected the Vayner. And this is one tool that is in the deluxe kit out of the seven. Now, I actually have all seven tools, but I'm going to just take this Vayner here. And I think you can get a close-up on that. And I'm going to do just three. Three different designs and prints out of one tool that you can create. Because I'm a firm believer, 75 to 80% of leather crafting is creativity. And having the insight and the knowledge of knowing what your various tools can do, you can take those seven tools and really, literally, you can stamp and print for years. And you can never, really, I don't even think you can be able to duplicate a lot of the prints and designs, because it'll keep coming to you the more you learn your tools and what your tools can do. So let's get this cracking. I've already taken out just a piece of scrap piece of belt blank. And it's already been pre-wet. I've already wet it already. I'm going to take my swivel knife here with my guide and just crease me out a border on these, just so I can give a quick insight. And now this video is going up on the YouTube, but I actually think that I'm going to do a live feed on Facebook too. So if you guys are plugged in to my social media pages, you can definitely come back and view those as well on the live feed. And again, this is just the regular. I'm just taking my swivel knife here and just cutting something very simple. And I'll show you guys what this is. That's all we've done. We just took the swivel knife and taking that out. And like, if this was the end tip of the belt, I could stamp the initials in there. Or if they wanted their name, all we have to do is just move those little swivel knife cuts back a little bit, stamp a name or something or whatever. But I started there just to give me a guide, point on now, and I think what I'm actually going to do too is take my wing divider, and I'm going to scribe me a center line. Just give me something to work with down the middle. So, and this is all done simply because I want to keep my stamping all uniform and dress right dress. That's all that is for, just to keep everything dress right dress. See, just scribe me a center line down there. Now, taking the cedar. And what I'm going to do is just, this is just simply going to make sure that everything stays dressed right. And this is just one quick print. Excuse me. It's raining down south and it's kind of helping beating the pollen down a little bit, which is great for my allergies. God knows it is. But just a quick stamp. And this is all to show you guys just what one tool can do. And just, like I said, again, take your time. Make sure everything is measured out right and everything is all uniform. Because that is what's most critical about customized work. And I want you to see this print in this design. See that there? Cool. That is just one. Now, I'm going to take and draw my swivel knife again, just to section off this part here so we can start again with something else. And one stamp with a cedar, three different prints. Now, the thing is, especially when you're doing stamping work on belts, you want to make sure that the other side of the belt is an exact mirror image of what you're putting on one side of the belt, so it will stay uniform and look good all the way across the back side of it. And there we have it. Stamp number two. See the difference? One cedar, one tool, different design. Now, I'm going to section this off again. And you guys are more than welcome. I mean, I don't own any particular... Let's see. Let's go this way this time. And it's simply just by changing, knowing what your tools can do. But let's give that a little bit of something else. And we still can do a still simple thing. I think I did that wrong from what I intentionally intended to do. But so I guess we're going to have to do four stamps, which won't be a problem because it's all quick work. And this is the great part about stamp. Different design than that one. Same tool, just simply turning the cedar from here, from this way, by just simply turning it over that way. And then it creates a whole different look. Same tool, three different looks. And I think what I wanted to do was this here. And so we're going to take the same one. Same tool. Flip that over to create the same exact image that we were going for. And I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you guys something that I love about this cedar. And it can do great things. You guys forgive me. I'm still battling allergies. Same tool. Same tool. And this is what we teach you guys in the workshop. How to take those tools and make them work for you. Look at that. Can you see that? Let me get a little light angle on that. One tool created that. Beautiful. And you can do a whole lot with this tool. And it's just amazing what you can do with it. But four different designs, one tool. And then you can even get super good and what we'll do is something like this. But this is why it's very important that no crafter, we don't throw away anything as far as scraps or anything like that. Because once you get to a point, I think I'm going to try it on this one here. Just taking one of the other existing designs and just doing something completely crazy with it. Taking that and just by simply tilting the tool, look at that. Give it a whole different look. That was one of the other ones, even from earlier. And I'll show you on this one here just to show you what I've done. All I did was I took this tool and I leaned it at a 45 degree angle, maybe a 35, just to get half of the stamp onto the leather. Just to get half of it on there. Not all of it. We don't want it to stamp all the way across. See? And it creates. Now you can even if you tilt it at a 45, turn that fan, turn this veiner back a little bit, and it gives it a completely different look. Doing a lot with a few tools. Doing a lot with a few tools. Just give it to something. You can play around with it. But there you have it. There you have it. One tool. So don't be dismayed even when you're buying those kits. Even though it has seven tools in it, only seven tools in there. Don't be dismayed at the amount of tools that they're giving you. Because actually when you start learning the tools and learning what shapes they can do and how to manipulate the leather and manipulate your, or not manipulate, but use your tools to create and manipulate different shapes with the leather, you can do a whole lot with it. This is Robert the Leather Cowboy Muhammad with Premier Leather Crafters down here in Alabama, Gaston, Alabama. Leather Workshop starts June the 3rd, lasts till June the 22nd, and then we take that last day, we do a big old party, and we showcase all of the students' pieces that they created over that eight-week period of time, and it's out there for everybody to see. You know, I hope you guys come back, chill with me again. Always to hit the subscribe button below. I'm always giving out good tips to save money and to increase your work, make your work look a little bit more professional right here on the YouTube. And I'll see you guys on the other side. Peace.